Grayson Thomas. This is Tozzi. This is Band Therapy, whatever. You guys know who it is. Tozzi had this great idea. You know, since we are the most inclusive cisgender cucks
on the face of the planet. We are the most intelligent out there. We know the most stuff, and I think we could really help people today and with all of their problems. So, yeah.
Tozzi had this very inoffensive idea
to basically help make a Hitchhiker's Guide to Being Trans. And we both individually came up with our own things. So Grayson had, you know, he actually came up with a PowerPoint. We're going to do that first, and then we're just going to go into mine. I'm sorry for cutting you off. Go ahead, continue what you're trying to say.
Well, you know, both of us know the struggles of being trans. And
yeah, obviously.
I think it would really help a lot of people if we give you... Not only because we know what it's like, but I think that we're very fair people. You know,
obviously.
We understand people's struggles.
We know what it's
just
like.
Want to help people. Yeah, this is not an attack on men or women. This is just
not
going to be a very... So, can you see my screen?
Probably. I mean, I can. Let's just hope it's recording it. I mean, it probably is. If not, you know, sorry guys. I also like how you spelled trans wrong.
Well, yeah. Well, here's the thing. This is a very, very, very visual presentation.
It's gonna be stimulating.
But, yeah. So this is my PowerPoint on: Are you a man or a woman? An essential guide on the pros and cons on who you should be if you convert to trans, all right? This is going to...
It's going to take you through... It's going to take you through the... I just now looked at the comprehensive or whatever that's trying to say.
Yeah, I totally didn't do this on purpose. This is going to be a comprehensive look on... At who you should choose to be if you decide to become transgender. This is going to be a neutral look pointing out the pros and cons of being a man or a woman. We are going into deep research. We have gone into deepest research about this topic. We have spent months, maybe even weeks, trying to write this presentation as neutral as possible. So strap in. Who should you be? Pros
Scott,
and cons.
Strap yourself
Would you
in.
Rather be a man or 2/5 human being?
Dude, you know they're 3/5. Jeez.
Women are less than black people.
Oh,
anyway,
sorry.
Ready? Let's see what we have to say about women.
I'm ready.
Women.
that Michelle Obama one is... Would you have sex with Obama, first of all? I would.
Well, first of all...
Let me
explain. So, this is about women. Women are nothing but fucking losers without penises.
Women. Whoa,
Gender of Michael Obama, who is actually a man. I didn't know if you knew this, but according to my sources, Michelle Obama is actually a man. All right?
Yeah.
All right? Men are cool. All right? Men roll. They're very cool. Very nice. We have very long cocks, unlike women. Actually do work instead of cutting themselves and beating their kids. All right. While women watch Grey's Anatomy dilling themselves,
yeah, seriously.
Men come after working and give their kids PTSD. And if you guys, if you little liberals did not know what PTSD stands for, it stands for pellets, tits, spear, and guns.
Oh my god. Oh my god. You did a mighty fine job on this. Can we, hold on, can we just like, can we do more presentations, please?
I'll try. I made this in like 20 minutes.
Yeah.
I barely put, because I haven't used presentation for so long, I forgot how most stuff works, so I'm like, I'll just put most things in Comic Sans. Anyway, but enough about that. I don't want to detract from this presentation because I'm very serious about this topic, all right? So, oh crap, wrong slide. Oh yeah, yeah. So, men also share gender. By the way, there's only two genders. Men also share gender with Donald Trump, all right? Now, if you know anything about Donald Trump, he is the greatest president ever.
Oh, my God.
And so, who do you choose? I want to know, who do you choose? Do you want to be a man or a woman? Once again, this is not trying to point out, I am not biased. Unlike the mainstream media.
Obviously.
I am not biased. Whoever you choose to be really should, you know, it should make you feel better, you know.
I mean, obviously.
So, yeah.
I mean, I'm just looking at that sign, the feminism one. That's really special. I like that. I like that a whole lot. So, in this destroy capitalism, that's a really great touch.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my
yeah.
God, this is one of the greatest presentations of all time. Thank you so much for, you know, giving us the honor of you know, looking at it. Now we're going to go, thank you Grayson for our intro slide, you know, to kind of develop the idea of the Hitchhiker's Guide to Being Trans, or what gender that you want to go for, you know, especially if you're non-binary, you're kind of caught in the middle, you know, like Dio once was, and you're just like, I don't know whether I should be, you know, male or female, right or wrong, right? So, basically, we're gonna go in depth with this. I really thought, you know, thought about this. I have maybe like 7 bullets per pro and con, and, you know, so I have like 28 of these. So, doing quick maths.
Quick maths.
What do you want to do first? Pros or cons? Women or male?
You know, since this is a positive episode of Band Therapy,
yeah,
let's go with pros first.
Pros of who?
Men.
Okay, actually, I'm just gonna do pros and cons of being a dude, and then we'll go over to women because it's easier to do that. You know, give a little bit of a structure to our intelligent, critical thinking.
I mean, this is basically, you know, the Lex Friedman podcast.
Basically,
it's only a matter of time that we have Elon Musk on here.
I was thinking more Neil deGrasse Tyson, but I think we can achieve Elon Tusk.
Yeah.
So,
Elon Musk invented Tesla.
So basically, pros of being a dude. Easier genitals to have, right? There's not a lot of upkeep. You don't bleed out of, you don't urinate blood out of your pee hole. It's just, you know, it's way easier. It's probably way easier to, you know, masturbate So yeah, here's another thing. You can pee anywhere. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And, you know, you need a funnel if you'd like to pee anywhere and you're a woman, you know. I'm just trying to say, I just think their genitals are more obsolete, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And
yeah.
Jake and I, every lunch period, we go to the bathroom or restroom and we just, we pee together like bros, okay? Mm-hmm. And Elena wishes she had a, you know, a peckerwood, a male swimsuit area, so she could pee with the boys. You know what I'm saying? You know,
I never thought about that. Like, women never get to experience standing next to their buddies while they relieve themselves.
Exactly. They'll never understand what I say in a restroom with other guys to kind of break the silence. I say some crazy stuff. So basically, you know, like, water's, you know, I'll drop a nickel, and I'll be like, water's cold today. So basically, as well, to add on to the, you know, pros of being a man, you won't ever have to cook or clean. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's just way easier. You'll have a woman for that, you know. Every man is paired up, like, they are pre-assigned a female to kind of dump into,
yeah.
And also mm-hmm. you have them cook and clean for them and just kind of, like, you know, take care of them, clean up after their mess, you know, they kind of bust and then they're like, clean up, you know, throw a towel on them and be like, clean up, you know? So, you also, being a dude, think about this once, guys, as, you know, my A-push teacher once said, you won't ever age as you are still a man. Whenever you get older, you are still a man, but women, at a certain age, women stop being women and just become old. You know what I'm saying? Men are still men. Women go from being women to old. Okay?
I mean, just look at Caitlyn Jenner.
Exactly. That is not a woman anymore. That is a straight up... That's just old. Okay? No gender.
Yeah.
We're also going to assign to you, if you become a woman and you are beyond the age of... I think 70, 65 is a good age, around there.
Yeah.
Okay. To say that you are an old and not a woman. So
I wish I could go back to 70, 65 to take back this country.
Yeah, me too. We all do, really. You know. I will say also, you won't be ashamed of having a lot of sex, you know. When you're a dude, they just, like, we praise each other for having a bunch of sex, but, you know, you'll get, you know, you'll buy your girlfriends and stuff. When you're a woman, you'll be called this and that. So, you know, also, being a man, you will have more money than a woman ever will in our whole entire lifetime.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, let's go to the cons of being a dude. I feel like that was a pretty solid pro list.
Yeah.
Cons of a dude: we have shorter lives than a woman. You know, it's mostly because we still stay men. It's probably just because we still stay men, and they get into the old part of their lives, and we never really phase.
Probably, like, cleaning and giving blowjobs every day probably adds like 10 years to your life every time you do it.
Exactly. When we bust into their mouths or inside of them, we give more life to them, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Once again, jizz is healthy, okay?
Yeah.
It's healthy for you. It's good for you. It's mm-hmm. kind of like Frosted Flakes, you know what I'm saying? Wink, wink.
Oh, I love Frosted Flakes. cum is so good for you.
Yeah, please take that off for everyone. Thank you. Also, we have lots of hair to keep up with. I'm not just saying that you and I, because we're long hair boys. I threw mine up in a bun. But, we also have a bunch of pubic hair, and, you know, if you're gifted with facial hair, you have a lot of that to keep up with. Also, you can't show your emotions. You know, you can't cry. Really, anger is really the only thing you can feel as a guy, and that's pretty much the only emotion that I ever feel. Also, you have to pay on dates. You know what I'm saying? Like,
that's very true.
If women are arguing about equality, why are they coming up to us? I mean, if you want to make things equal, pay for my meal. Jesus Christ. You know?
And clean up unprompted.
Yeah, clean up unprompted. All right. So basically, also, I'm not taking it.
I've had enough.
Yeah, I have had enough. Also, you weren't able to go to the restroom with friends. You know what I'm saying? Like, women do that all the time. It's kind of weird for a man to do that. Just listen to Daniel Sloss. He has some pretty good, pretty good stories about it. You know, I whenever I'm able to do it, I do it. You know what I'm saying? And if there's someone in there and it's an awkward situation, yeah, I just straight up, I just say, like, man, it hurts to pee, you know. I really shouldn't have slept with that woman, you know what I'm saying? Like, it burns when I pee, you know, I contracted something, I have no idea what it was. She looked like she had a little bit of stank on her, and I misjudged whether I should have a condom or whatever. Maybe she poked a little hole because, you know, she did have some of that stank on her. So, you know how tricky they are. You know how tricky women are. So, Wei Xiong Xian. So, basically, you also have to make the first move romantic-wise. You know what I'm saying? Like, you
not
gotta...
Not if you're Delta.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, if you're not a tomboy, or you're not dating a tomboy, and you are a dude, you kind of have to make the first move.
And you're dating a real woman.
Yeah, you gotta ask him out. You gotta make the first move with, you know, you gotta kiss her first. You gotta do all of that. Also, what's up with this? You get called gay a whole lot being a guy. So, I guess that's and we all know gays are wrong, so, I mean, what's up with that? It's not cool.
I mean,
it's the worst con on that list, is getting called gay.
Equality, for equality, we gotta start calling more women lesbians.
I'm sorry. Eggs are just eggs in my book. So, basically, pros of a woman... they live longer lives. Basically.
And if you're a man thinking about becoming a woman, you'll definitely live longer.
Yeah, exactly. And all of this applies if you just say that you're switching genders, all of this will automatically apply to you in, you know, you'll get all the pros and also the cons.
Yeah.
You know, it's just what it is, cuz. So basically,
just look at Caitlyn Jenner.
Exactly. Let's look at us. You can cry and complain about literally everything. Okay. And nobody will look at you weird for it. They'll just be like, "Aw, that's sad. I want to get up inside her." So basically. You know, you gotta take care of her so you have a possibility and a chance of getting in. It's like a fraternity. So basically, you can get away with most of everything, really. With sexuality, right? And, I mean, you can enter clubs or whatever, and you can, you know what you have to do? That's all you have to do, okay?
Well, what if you're delirium and you don't have any tits?
Delirium? Well, I mean, that was off-key. Munis Boys. I don't think she's not considered a woman.
That's true, yeah.
Okay, there's...
If you don't have state troopers,
yeah,
you are not a woman.
Yeah, and also, the whole old thing, and you're not a woman when you're old, it also applies to how attractive you are. So if you're ugly, you are not a woman. And that's just a clear fact. So you're just like a bag of sand at that point, really.
Yeah, just broad sand.
Exactly. And I mean, like, you can get away with rape. So it's just how it is, okay? You say you want equality, pay for my meal, and, you know, confess to that rape, okay? Because it's not cool.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know? I mean, and also, like, if you want equality, you know, and you want to peg me, maybe let me try and, you know, peg you. So basically...
Yeah, just look at Caitlyn Jenner.
Or vice versa. If I'm pegging you, let you peg me, alright?
Yeah.
Equality. Just like how it is in our song. What's the name? I don't remember the names of my own songs. I Want. Off of the Crimbus album. It's Crimbus time again. Ellipses again. Exclamation mark. Listen to it. So yeah. Also, you can just straight play with your boobs all day. You can just, like, you know,
Well, look, if you're fat like me, you can do that as a man as well.
Yeah, but it doesn't feel, I mean, I've been fat, I felt my boobs, nothing compares to a woman's breast. So basically, you can also hide things up your puss. You know what I'm saying?
That is very true.
You can just, like... Let's just say if your car breaks down and you need a wrench, you can just kind of, like, fish it out of your puss.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I mean, you can...
A little coin slot puss.
Right, right. If you're, like, if you're going to Aldi's and you're like, man, I really need 25 cents right now, you know, be like, swing, swing, you know,
So that's why the shopping carts at Aldi's are always so slimy.
Exactly, and that's also why, you know, women always have carts, but men have those little baskets or whatever, or just, yeah, you know. Mm-hmm. Basically, you also have, you know how they say that people with mental disabilities and who can't think as well as, you know, the normal people... You know how they say they have a happier life?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you for your answer. You know, so women, we all know that they're less intelligent than men. They're just way stupid. They're like, I'm not even sure if they've evolved along with the progression of, you know, men.
I mean,
and humanity.
I think you get the same pleasure fucking a chimp, you know?
Yeah, exactly. Humanity. It's right in the name, okay? And it's not humanity. Put that up your books. Come on. Jesus Christ. And Queefa. So basically, you know, you can have a happier life with stupidity. And I mean, you can also think about this, okay?
Queefa.
I think we're getting solid points, and I think by the end of this podcast, you know, the non-binary person or whatever, if you're thinking about switching over, you will have, yeah, a good.
We are giving spitting straight facts.
Right, we're just. FAX, we're sending straight facts, and like, I think we're giving out the good knowledge, and they will know by the end of this podcast, the end of this video.
I mean, even Dr. Drew, even Dr. Drew agrees.
You know, women are just stupid. He's got
that scientific facts, you know?
Yeah. And that's, you know, that's a doctor. Hey, everyone trusts doctors, right?
Yeah.
I mean, Matt Smith, David Tennant, you know, Tom Baker, everyone trusts a doctor. So basically, you know, you can take as long as you want when you're getting ready. You know, that's pretty cool. I want to have some free time. I want to take an hour to, you know, put a bra on. You know what I'm saying? And also, what's up with this excuse, okay? Like, women just can get away with everything, not only due to with sexuality and just, like, you know, exposing a part of yourself, but you can also get away with saying girl problems, and then you can just, like, get away with doing anything. If you're like, you know, hey, can I go out with my friends tonight? You know, they're like, and no. And then, you know, you're talking to your dad, and then you're like, you know, girl problems. You can get away with it, right? If you're like, man, I really need to use the restroom, you know, you can just say girl problems, and they'll excuse you. Or you're like, hey, my assignment's late, and then the teacher's like, screw you, you're gonna have to S my D for it. And then they're, you know, and then you're like, girl problems, and then they're like, ugh, okay, never mind. So basically, here are finally, you thought that was a cons list, but no, that's how bad women are. Here are now the cons.
Oh, no.
Periods. Yeah. I mean, like, that's an obvious one. Having children, I mean, who wants to have a child? One of my favorite things about being a man...
who wants to have a child?
Nobody... Yeah, exactly. Nobody wants to have a children. I mean, being a man, you can just bust and then, like, go on your merry way, right? That's your right as a man. Yeah. All right? Yeah. And then if they're like, hey, I want child support, give them money for an abortion. If they don't go through with that, guess what? I'm pretty sure you can cut hair with a gun. You know, I don't have to pay for your college.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus Christ. So basically, you also can't think and comprehend as well as men. All right, that's just a clear fact, right? I really hope this goes viral, by the way. I am...
This is going to be such a hit on r/incel. This is going to be such a hit.
I hope so. I'd like to say that, you know, you and I are both joking about this, but no, we really aren't. So basically, I really hope Yanni and Chrissy pick.
Well, we would never joke about things like this.
Of course not. And I feel like Mommy Tina and, you know, in the actual main mommy, because, you know, he's a man, the one who actually runs this stuff. Actually, a Jew runs it. All, because you know how they are. So, you know, I really hope Nadav finally isn't a Jew about all of this and actually picks up our stuff. By the way, I sent you Deepest Cuts music and you never responded. Jesus Christ.
Are you talking to me or women?
I'm talking to the Jew, Nadav.
Oh.
Jesus Christ. Get on my level, bro. So basically, you know, can't think and comprehend as well as men. You also aren't strong and can't play sports. So, I mean, that's obviously, like, the one of the biggest cons. You know, I mean, if you can't even open a jar of pickles. Like, get on our level, okay? Jeez. You also can't have any interests. And that's another thing that goes along with the stupidity thing. Basically, all I could have written on here is stupid, and I didn't have to explain myself. But basically, you know, you can't have any interest, mostly because you're not smart enough to, you know, actually comprehend, you know, having interest. I actually have no idea what I was going to say about, you know, you can't have any interest. I think it also goes along with you're just cooking and cleaning all day, that you really can't have any free time. You know, also...
You've put so much thought into this whole list.
Have not put any thought into this. This took me all of 5 minutes to do. This is just all of, you know, this is all of my actual thoughts, and this isn't a joke whatsoever. So, You have to cook and clean. I mean, I know I've said this a whole lot, but I mean, like, come on. If you're... I get so angry about this, because if you're a man going to be a woman, like, or transitioning into a woman, you're just like, why? You were born with greatness, and then you're just like, oh, I'm going to have a way worse life. Like, come on. Like, what is wrong with you? What is wrong with you that you're like, I guess I got to make my life worse? Jesus Christ.
Hey, you know, if you're a man and you feel guilty about making a lot of money, just become a woman.
I mean, yeah. I have no idea. And the whole thing can also be like, you, like, being a woman, you can, you know, talk to more women and you finally won't be alone in your life. But also, like, you're already a man, so I mean, like, all you have to do is just kind of, like, push yourself onto them, because rape isn't a thing, okay? And I want you to know that. All you have to do is pick yourself up, just a couple of roofies, and go on your merry way and have a fun time, all right?
And also, if you've ever fantasized about fucking women while they're taking a shit, just become a transvestigender.
Yeah.
And then go into bathrooms and rape them, because we all know how common that is.
Yeah. So, I mean, it's just what it is. All right. And
yeah, it is what it is.
Yeah, exactly. And, you know, also oral. Okay. I mean, if you're a man going into a woman, first of all, we all know this isn't real, okay? You're still a man, and there's no way to transition into another gender because you're wrong and stupid. You know, and make no mistake, I voted for Donnie T, you know? But I just want to say homosexuality is wrong if you're still a man blowing another man, okay? What is wrong with you? You know, and it... Like I just said, homosexuality is wrong. It's a sin. Mm-hmm. Don't do it. It's bad.
Leviticus 20:13.
Yeah, exactly. Leviticus 20:13.
Take it, Uvas.
You know, also, this just goes along with everything that I've been saying here tonight, but God made them more, you know, God made them inferior to men. So, I mean, like, I think that's my closing statement. If I were in court arguing about this, I would have won. I would have won, all right? That's just what it is.
I mean, if you really want to talk about superiority, look at these two men. Can you see these two men?
Yeah. Hitler
and
Trump.
You got Hitler. You got Trump. Probably, like, I don't know. Erwin Rommel.
Oh, well, that's Swayze. And the other guy there is Travolta.
Oh, yeah.
Hitler, Trump, and Swayze, and Travolta.
Cool people.
Just cool guys.
Now, unlike these two women.
Yeah, what's wrong with them? Jeez. So basically.
Anyway. God, this meme is so bad.
No.
I, by the way, did my favorite part of the presentation is the uncropped phone screenshot.
I know. That's one of my favorite things. But basically, I think I've won.
Oh, no.
I think I've, you know, I gave solid evidence. And hopefully, you're going to stick to being a man, or you're going to cross over being a man. Actually, don't even cross over being a man, because, you know, you're still a woman biologically, and you just, you have no right to be a man, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Or even being a presence of a man, unless you're cooking or cleaning or stimulating them, if you know what I'm saying. So,
yeah,
you know, I basically forget what I was about to say. Also, did you see the one meme on the r/your mom's house podcast subreddit of the one guy who's just... like, going on about how liberals can't take away their guns. And then he straight up, he was like, yeah, this liberal come, you know, if you want to take my guns, kiss me softly on the lips. Do you see that? Actually, I think I sent that to you.
I mean, I've seen so many videos that are just like that I've probably seen that video before.
We also forgot to get into your text messages, or, like, what I've sent you before. So
my phone's dead right now,
Okay. But basically,
let's save it for the next podcast.
Exactly.
That'll come out in 3 weeks. So.
Yeah. I mean, well, actually, when they're listening to this one, it will come out in a week. But yeah, I think I've said a lot of good stuff. I've made my point clear. I'm kind of like Atticus Finch, you know? I won the case. Actually, he didn't win
Scout.
The... That's why I'm better than Atticus Finch, is because I won the case, okay? And, you know, it's...
Scout?
Yeah, it's...
If you see two trannies walking down the street, pay them no mind.
Are you... Yeah. Are you... Well, first of all, are you brought back to life? Sir, what was James Bond's name?
I don't remember.
He was Indiana Jones' dad. Why can't I think it's okay to slap a woman? I don't know why.
Well, it's not Sean Connery.
Yes, it is,
right?
Sean Connery. 50 no's and a yes means yes. So basically, yeah, thank you for joining. Also, we forgot to say rest in peace to Sean Connery. What is that?
Oh, yeah.
We named the dog Indy. So, I mean, like, it's just what it is. Cause,
rest in peace, suck it, Trebek, so.
Yeah. And I think this will go viral. I want to have a closing statement of... we're both liberals. This is all just a joke. And also, I mean, I feel like we have to clarify, you know what I'm saying? But I just want to say that...
I think we made that abundantly clear. I don't think we have to say that.
I don't care, dude.
I mean, I obviously wasn't joking, right?
I don't think we both were joking. I know that sound...
Yeah, we were 100%.
We're 100%.
100%.
And yeah. We weren't joking mm-hmm. whatsoever. I think we should do more slides. I don't think yeah. we can do the slide of our choir.
You know how I literally looked up, like, pro-Trump meme and then just clicked on, like, the worst possible things that I could find? And then
I just
was, like,
farted, by the
I
way.
Realized
that was
after,
clear, I don't know.
I realized, like, after... I, like, made the presentation that it might be one of the greatest things I've ever made. So,
yeah.
You know,
so...
It might, you know...
Mm-hmm.
Maybe, if anything, that's one thing Trump has really made... mean my life great again.
Right,
so.
Right. Anyway, so... We've given great points. Go and pick your side, everyone. Go and pick your side. And
crap, I just had a pick.
I hope you guys have a great week.
Oh shit.
Have a great Monday.
I just turned off my monitor. God damn it. Okay, everything's good.
Yeah, so you wanna give the closing statements, bro?
Yeah, so women aren't real, God is fake, and hail Trump. Alright, good night.
Hail Trump, ta-ta.
Adrian. See, you don't know about it. So you're not ready for it. Well, me, I'm Sinistah Slayback. About to put it on the track. Band therapy issues scaring me. Acting like I killed a beat. Eating your poopery seat. You wanna be hot and Cherokee. Hyperbole, you know, sexuality. Strive for so much. Get rhinoplasty. Thrive your soft touch. Never get it back. Crack utter feedback of your plaque. Your surgery, a paid fee. Listen, he no longer wants beautiful, no more quality. Appointee, you disappoint me. Supposed to be a therapy session, but I can't ask my questions due to aggression, to your depression. A facial expression that is now regression. I know that this can cost and break you. Bourgeoisie trying to make you pay paper. Dictator is not your creator, only a player. Unholy the traitor. Put some labor in and slip with the razor. Vindicators trying to make you feel a laser. Let's get back on track. I'm trying to say, Rick Skull is straight gay, but I'll murder ya.